Thanks a lot, Bob. Well, the Nets tonight, they hold the Raptors under 40% shooting. Normally, Brooklyn's going to win the game if they're able to do that on the defensive end. But tonight, just could not get shots to drop, Richard. Some good looks, but could not get them to drop, especially from three.
Yeah, and I was a little critical of Garrett Temple, and it's more because I believe he can do more. We talk so much about Joe Harris. Joe Harris goes to the cup a lot more, and he's one of the more prolific, efficient three-point shooters in the NBA. But he still has that balance of getting to the cup, and I think, you know, tonight was a night that the three-point shot didn't fall, turned the ball over a lot. You combine those two things in this type of atmosphere against that quality of a team, it's going to be very difficult to get a win.
You know, we saw quality minutes off the bench for David Nwaba, but we have seen with the Nets bench during this stretch, while they don't have Kyrie Irving, while they don't have Caris LeVert, a lot of times they're trying to survive until those starters get back in. What has to be the mindset for this group coming off the bench as they're playing their minutes in the second, in the third, in the fourth quarter, and like what we're going to see tomorrow against Philadelphia?
Well, there still has to be a bench mob mentality. It's like, together we are better. They got to move the ball. They got to fight for each other. They have to make the extra pass. Sometimes when you drive a ball, it's not for yourself, it's for the other person, because you don't have the individual one-on-one talent. So if we have to look at it and say, how can we collectively do this better? That means more communication on defense, all the different things that make that group a little bit tighter. And I think they will find it, and eventually when you get healthy, you'll move Spencer back to the bench, and then you'll have your floor general for that second unit. And so I think the future is bright. They just have to get through this patch.
All right, this patch also includes a behemoth of an opponent on the second half of this back-to-back. That's the Philadelphia 76ers, who've been playing great basketball. They're more beatable on the road, no doubt. But what are some of the things the Nets will have to key in on if they want to compete with Philadelphia tomorrow?
Well, you're going to have to rebound the ball, and you're definitely going to have to shoot the ball well. You look at the way that the Nets have shot the ball tonight. That's going to be an issue if you're talking about the size of all the guys that are in Philly. You got Ben Simmons, you got Joel Embiid, you got Tobias Harris. That is a big, big team. So the only way to kind of neutralize their way they rebound and the way they can beat you up in the paint is to shoot the ball well.
Well, the Nets will have the chance to do so, facing another good opponent. Kenny Atkinson called this back-to-back a wonderful challenge. One of those two games down, the other one coming tomorrow, as we send it back to you in the studio, Bob.